with the real flow. Signing out, ES News, Andy Emilio, and why. Here with the golden child himself, Andy Emilio, Lil B-Hop, Chris Colbert. Talk about it. Coming up, man, big fight. This is like the step up fight. This is for both of y'all.
For me?
Yeah, you don't think so? Never?
Never.
I mean, it's the first guy that has like kind of a name where like you guys are both big prospects, you know what I'm saying?
Who knows him? Besides people in New York.
People in New York. So I guess, you know, you're taking them lightly or you've been...
I don't take nobody lightly, but okay. I know this is levels to this boxing shit.
All right.
And he's not on my level.
So what can the fans expect then? With that being said, he's not on your level.
If I don't stop him, I'm going to whip his ass badly.
That's a big statement right there.
I don't stop him because he's not he's not even a four round fighter. He get tired in four. If I don't stop him, I'm gonna beat his ass bad. I'm not here to do the talking. You know me, I like to talk a lot, but for what? My name says it all. What I do in the ring says it all. So I don't gotta say much. He know what he getting himself into, and I know what I'm getting myself into. And I know come November 4th I will be victorious.
That being said, has anything changed in the regimen, training camp? Has this put like a chip on your shoulder that people, that the media seem to think, okay, this is like a good match?
No, because all the media knows who the real B-Hop is.
Okay.
The media know what time it is. They know what I bring to the table and they know what he brings to the table. They've been there for his Barclays Center performance as a pro and they've been there for mine. And who is more better? You tell me. A second round knockout or a four round decision when you get dropped twice? Tell me. And this is the beginning of your pro career. You're not even supposed to be game. Hit. Better yet, drop. It's levels. Trust me. Levels to this shit. And we all know I'm on a different level.
Now, you guys have had sparring in the past, correct?
Yeah, definitely.
So you kind of have a feel for him already in the ring.
I know his every move. I teach him what he does. If you want to get technical, we can go back into some old videos and ask some old people that was there fighting about himself, how he got that victory. Because of me. He was sitting ringside and coaching me. When he comes to the corner, he looked at me. And when I went to his
So this is kind of like the student and the master.
I'm the master. You know that. And when I went to his locker room, I told him, where's my 10%? I helped you get that victory, so you might as well pay me, right? He know what time it is, though.
And what he say to that?
You know, when he say that, he laughed. But we're cool. I'm not got no problem with the kid.
Yeah.
It's just business and it's gotta be done. And I'm gonna handle my business coming down the floor. Either I'm gonna knock him out, stop him, or I'm gonna beat his ass bad. Watch us.
How do you do that, man? We're like, you separate the business from, like you said, you guys are cool and stuff, you know, like, how do you turn that on to get there in the ring and hurt somebody who you know, giving advice to?
Shit. You ever watch WWE?
Yeah.
You know Festus?
Nah, I haven't kept up with the new guys.
It's not that new, but when the bell rings, you click on it, no matter who.
Okay.
That's how I am. When that bell rings, no friends. They put my mother in there, I'm gonna whoop my ass.
Oh, damn. That's gonna be the caption right there, man.
That's how you know it. You put my mom in there, you know I whoop her ass. So you don't come November 4th. It's just another day in the office for me.
Nah, but let everybody know, because I know they gonna be like, who's this kid? Life, so the crew for life.
November 4th, you see.
They gonna be like, this kid is talking shit, man. I might have seen him on the documentary.
So
just let him know your record. Talk about it a little bit.
I know I talk shit, but I back it up.
Go ahead. So give him a little intro about your record, your resume, and all that.
I mean, my resume is nothing compared to these world champions right now. So that's not really to be talked about, but I'm undefeated.
Okay.
As I should be.
Mm-hmm.
I had no close fights, as I should have. Being an undefeated fighter, just my second undefeated fight, I'm about to be. So, I mean, I'm just doing what I gotta do, man. Taking these guys out one by one, stepping my way up in the ranking.
All right, now, I gotta talk to you about boxing, because you're one of my fave boxing guys to talk boxing with. So let's get into some fights, man. Gotta talk about it, in or around your weight class. Loma, Rigondeaux, technical, you know, Matrix, all that.
I think Rigo gonna win.
Okay.
I'm going to Camp Rigo right after my fight, the day after. So it's no days off. We're gonna be right back in camp with the world champion the next day.
Have you ever been in camp with Riggo before?
Of course I did.
Okay, all right.
Ask him about it.
Hey, man, what's happening?
Okay.
I don't got much to say. I ain't got much to talk about. They all know what I do. Even world champions like Riggo down himself know what I bring to the table.
That says a lot if Riggo brings you in for a look.
Oh, no, Lomachenko. This is not the first time. This is the third time he's called me in for camp.
Before a look for Loma, that's good because you know you guys are both southpaw.
I'm the first person he called when it's time for camp for him. Because he know any way he want it. If he want me to put the pressure, I'm going to bring it to him. Mm-hmm. I'm not scared to take the punch. I'm not scared to take a punch and a piece. And boxing, that's what I do. I don't like to get hit. So.
All right, so you're a guy. I've seen you hold mitts. Like you said, you give advice outside the ring, etc. What advice, Riggo's the shorter guy, smaller. He do got some long ass arms. Loma's bigger, at a heavier weight. He's coming up to his weight class. What's your game plan for him?
Be smart. Use that power, catch him with big shots. We never seen Lomachenko really get hit. By no big puncher and somebody that's smart and fast like Lomachenko. I'm ready now, so.
Gotta talk about it. Danny Jacobs, one of your big bros, got a big HBO deal. You know, he's chasing him, man. He's chasing Triple G and Canelo. Back for that. Who do you think he matches up well against between them? And how do you see those fights matching up now that he's with HBO?
Fight with anybody.
Okay.
Like I told you when he fought Triple G. Mm-hmm. What I told you.
That he was going to whip his ass.
And what happened? He didn't whip his ass, but he gave him business.
Yeah.
And it was a debatable fight that I thought he should have won.
Do you think he'll get those fights again, or do you think he's going to be ducked?
Definitely. He should get those fights. He deserves those fights, right?
He do.
But fuck that fight. Let's talk about Erickson Lubin versus Charlo.
All right. Yeah, go ahead. Let's talk about it. Break it down.
On Saturday night, Mr. Charlo, he's going to meet Jack, and he's going to meet Sledge.
Okay. So you got Jack and Sledge in this one.
It's hammer time, baby.
All right. Hammer time all day, man. Well, that's a hell of a shout out. Let everybody know where they can follow you, social media, etc.
Yeah, follow my new Instagram, @the_goldenchild. My Facebook, Christopher TGC Colbert. That's it, really. I'm not really too big on social.
And they can check out that Netflix, man.
Yeah, come see me November 4th. That's where you can check
them out. November 4th, man. Barclays.